Hey y'all, guess what day it is? Bow, guess what day it is? Bow, guess what day it is? It's Vlogmas Day 12. So it's 12-12-22. Manifest, bitch. It's weird, look a mess, but I'm at work. It's 9:10 right now. I'm in between my sessions. So I didn't know I do moonlight as a speech therapy assistant. So yeah, I have two jobs. My day job is this, being a speech therapy assistant. And then at night, I wait tables for some extra moolah. I've been a therapy assistant this past year, because I was gonna take y'all to work with me this morning, but like I was gonna do a whole like come to work with me, spend a productive day with me. I almost missed it in, but not to nothing I did. The shit was just early. Like, you wanna be late, you wanna be early, but you don't wanna be on time. I was running, child. I was running. And I had this heavy ass book bag on me with my laptop, and I had to bring some stuff from my office on my desk that I needed little supplies and stuff. I literally made it by the skin of my teeth, like, and I was ducking and dodging cars and everything, trying to run across the street to get to the bus stop, because the bus stop was right across the street from my house, so it only take me 2 minutes to get there. But still, that bitch ain't early, because I can track the bus on the app. Marta has an app where you can track to see where the bus is. This wig look a freaking mess, and that shit was right by my house, and I was like, oh fuck. So I had to, like, oh my god. And I did legs yesterday. So my legs was like, bitch, what are you doing? Why are you trying to run right now? What's going on? I felt that shit. My freaking quads are done. My quads are so sore to the freaking touch. Like, I cannot wait to go off. I might take a hot ass bath. I am a therapy assistant. I have been doing it since January. Y'all can see my little office. They got me in the fucking storage closet. Like, legit. It's like a storage closet. This is my office. I wanted to like decorate and like get a little, but I'm just like, look at all these fucking boxes, like all this shit. When I first came here, because at the beginning of the school year, well, I first started working in this field in January, because I did go to college. I graduated in 2018 from Old Dominion University in Norfolk, Virginia. Woo, 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 woo. Go Monarchs. I got a bachelor's in speech and language pathology and audiology with a minor in special education. Honestly, people ask me all the time, well, what made you wanna become a speech therapist? I picked it out of a hat. Like, people keep asking me, like, and they be so surprised, but I'm like, ain't that how life go? Like, you just pick a random career and you just do it, one that sounds semi-interesting. So I ended up, literally, I was undecided, because when I first got to college, I was like, okay, I want to be a doctor. I want to be either an anesthesiologist or a medical examiner. I wanted to be one of the two. So when you go to college and you express that you want to do like a science related field, like pre-med or something like that, they put you in the pre-med sciences, not the basic sciences. Boy, all it took was that biology class. That shit took me out. I was like, oh no. The lecture was fine. It was the lab. We had all these different slides with different diseases, and we had to recognize them just based off looking at them. I was like, no, I can't. I cannot. Like, I flunked out of that shit. I dropped that class, and I dropped it late in the semester too. That shit fucked my financial aid up and everything. So then I was like, okay, maybe I'll just major in English, because I'm really good at writing papers, I'm good at English, all that good stuff. So I was like, okay, I'll do that. But I don't like writing. I don't like to write. So I just didn't know what I was majoring in. I was undecided for a long time. Then come my sophomore year, you have to take a class. If you're still undecided, they had a class at ODU where basically it was like career exploration. So it would just explore different careers. We had different people coming in. And that class, I gotta say, the class was fine. It was an easy A, but it was a waste of money. And those classes are, you know, college classes are like at least $1,000 each. That was a waste of a stat. At the end, all we did was take a quiz, and it gave you recommendations based on your answers and then what majors they had at the school. And my top thing was audiology, or like something to do with like sign language. And it was like, okay, the matching thing with that is speech and language pathology. So I started Googling it, I looked into it, and I really enjoyed it. And I graduated. To be an actual therapist, you have to go to school for, you have to get your master's, and that takes 2 years, and then you can be like an actual licensed therapist. But I did not go to get my master's. Life just happened after graduating from undergrad. And I just had took a break, and now it's been 5 years, and I'm finally going back next year. I will be attending. Right now, it's looking like I'm going to a school online. I won't say the name of it, but it's looking like I'm going to a school online. But I have to see, because that school is like $80,000. I'm just like, oh, girl, hold on now. I don't know if I want to spend that much money, but the school is very specialized. Like, when I tell people that I am a speech therapist, a lot of people just think like this. Like, you work in schools, you work with kids, like, you work on, like, sounds. Like, oh, you can't pronounce your R's or your S's or your TH's or whatever. Like, but it's so much more than that. Like, the whole field of speech therapy. Like, I even don't know everything that I could do as a speech therapist. Like, I just met a therapist who works at colleges, and she works with the football players to help them, you know, speak better during their interviews and stuff like that. And I'm like, who would have thought that that's a fucking, I know you can do, like, it is so many different jobs that you can do in my field of work. My hair, oh, I hate this wig. It's so many different things that you can do in my field of work. Like, you can work, like I said, lady in the colleges. You can work with actors doing accent reduction or, you know, accent modification. Like, they have to play a role and they need to, you know, speak a certain way. You can help them with that. You can do, you can work in hospitals, you can work people with brain injuries, because obviously some part of your brain helps you speak. So if you have a brain injury, you need to relearn all that again. If you have an injury to your throat, maybe you drive in or something happens here, this is where your vocal cords are, your vocal folds. And so if there's injury to that, then you need rehabilitation. And as a therapist, I have, you know, I can do certain studies, get certain exams, certain like machines that they put down your nose to look at your vocal folds and see what's going on down there. Like, you can work in schools, clinics, you can open your own practice, you could travel. Like, there are so many different like facets to this field, so many different paths to this field, and that's why I love it. I feel like, how could I ever really get bored when I can literally just switch up at any time? Long as you license, you could do what the fuck ever. I mean, I'm sure they might want some experience. My plan is to go back to school next year, and I'm doing leveling courses, which means that for the first like probably 2 semesters, I'm just gonna be retaking my undergrad courses because I need a refresher. Like, I can't just jump into graduate level courses, and it's been 5-6 years since I graduated undergrad. Like, that's not fair to me. That's not fair to the money I'm spending to go to school. That's not fair to my future patients. Like, I need to have this shit down pat. So I'm starting from the basics. Yes, it's gonna take me like 2.5, maybe 3 years to do it, but I don't care. It's gonna be done. Then after that, I definitely plan on getting my doctorate. Yeah, I'm trying to be Dr. Courtney Renee Young. And I don't know, it's only a couple of schools in the country, because getting a doctorate in speech therapy, you can get your PhD. I'm not doing that. That's like 7 fucking years. I wish the fuck I would. I'm getting my clinical doctorate, which is just 2 more years of schooling. So yeah, I'm nervous about it. I'm excited, but I really do enjoy my job. I like working with the kids. I like the variety. The thing I like about working in schools is the fact that it's pretty routine. Like, I have a schedule and I stick to that schedule. You know what I'm saying? Like, I know what I'm be doing. Like, I know my cases. Typically with school age children, it's things like articulation, which is again not being able to say certain sounds, maybe fluency problems, which is like stuttering or stammering, things of that nature. And that's a lot of language. Like I say, I'm a speech and language pathologist. Most people just say speech therapist. They forget the language part, like figurative language, expressive language, receptive language, so things like following directions, listening, being able to sequence events, being able to inference. Actually, the child I'm about to go see right now, I need to go get her. Oh, she is just so this is my first time working in high school. Like I said, I just started doing this in January, because whenever I graduated from undergrad in 2018 in Virginia, there were no speech and language pathology assistants. So that's what I am. I'm an SLPA, but they're not all over the country. Like, it's only certain states that allow SLPAs. I feel like all states should allow them. It'll save the money for one, and it'll also help with the therapist caseload. So I have a supervisor over me at all times. I mean, She ain't really physically here today, but I have a supervisor that's over me at all times. She does the testing, she does evaluating, she does scoring, she writes, like, she does, like, the heavy stuff. Like, I just do the therapy sessions. Like, I plan them, I take data, I can give recommendations based off my notes or my interactions with the child about what I think that we should do or shouldn't do as far as, but I can't dismiss a child from therapy. I can't recommend a child for therapy. I can't test. I can't evaluate. I can't score evaluations or score tests. I cannot talk to parents. I'm not really supposed to talk to teachers. I cannot go to the meetings and really, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's a lot of stuff I'm not supposed to do. Like, I'm here to assist the therapist, which means I run the therapy sessions. And my last location, my last site, school that I was at was the same way, but my therapist was there every day. Like, she was there every single day. Always there. She was right beside me at all times, but I still ran a therapy. I plan it. I like all this crap. This is my shit of games and stuff to do during therapy. Like, you gotta build up build up a collection of shit that you can just pull from. Like, this girl I got right now, like I said, this student, she has inferencing goals. Every time she come in here though, she always like, first time working in high school, my first time working with teenagers. I really don't like teenagers like that. But these kids are very respectful. They're very nice. It's just a select few. Honestly, it's not even a select few. My elementary, because the school I was at before was pre-K to 8th grade. They were more rowdy than these kids are. Like, the kids I get, they're like, yes, ma'am, ma'am, no, ma'am, yes, please. Like, they are so freaking polite. They are so nice. Like, I was so surprised because I was so scared to come here. I was like, this would be East Side Hop in this bitch. They're very, I need to brush my hair because it's freaking bothering me, you know? I'm here from about 8 a.m. because I take the bus. I'm here from about 8 a.m. until 4 p.m. I leave at 4. Sometimes I leave later than that if we have a meeting or something. I had curls in this wig, but you know, they fail. I didn't feel like putting them in because I'm off tomorrow. And then the day after that, well, up until next, I ain't even really glue this shit down. Up until next year, next semester, I'm just gonna be working at the hotel. So that's why I wanted to go ahead and record this, so y'all can get like a little day in my life. Well, all y'all gonna see is me in this office because I'm very keen about confidentiality and keeping where I work at private because I'm in the storage closet and I work with kids and, you know, I don't know. I'm real iffy about that. Still look a mess. I, as a therapist, I want to work in hospitals. I think, like I said, it's so many, this part, it's just this piece right here that's like, really bothering me. But I want to work in hospitals and I want to work with patients with voice and swallowing disorders, which obviously voice is a part of speech therapy and swallowing again is a part of speech therapy because if you got problems, I don't know, it's just a part of it, you know, swallowing, voice, articulation, it's a lot of stuff. It's a lot of different stuff that is all encompassed in the speech therapy. Let me figure out what me and this little girl is gonna be doing. Every time she come here, like I said, she's like, I don't know. And I'm like, what I wish these kids understood is that if you really came in therapy and you really try, if you hate it that much, really try. Like, really try and get good at it. Because if you don't get good at it, you're not going anywhere. But if you get good at it, you can be dismissed eventually. Because I think they're reevaluated, I think in this county, every three years. So it's like, if you got your evaluations is coming back around, you do what you gotta do, you can go. Not her. I don't know. Whole little attitude. I just be like, bruh, the fuck? I'm here for you, my nigga. Like, I'm not judging you. This is a judgment-free zone. Like, and I make it a point to like let the kids know, like, I don't know everything. I do not know everything. It's some stuff that I don't know. When I don't know a word or something, I don't know. Let's look it up together. I'm saying, I don't know everything. I'm still learning. It's a lot of stuff that, you know, is hard for everybody. Oh gosh, I can just hear her now. I don't know. I don't understand. I don't know. So I try to make this shit as easy as possible, but it's not really, I mean, you know, a great thing going down the elementary level stuff. And we're in high school here, but she keeps saying she don't know. Maybe she just genuinely doesn't know. Maybe she doesn't have attitude. Maybe she just doesn't know. But yeah, that's what I want to do after I get my degree, work in hospitals, I think. And then eventually, I want to be a professor. So I'm going to be Dr. Courtney Young. Excuse me, Dr. Courtney Renee Young. Dr. Young, yes. Dr. Young, yes. Yes, professor. Yes. I don't know why. I just want to be a professor. I think that shit lit as fuck. Like, shaping young minds in the field that I'm in. Like, giving my experience and stuff. But let me pick out Kahoot. I live on Kahoot. I'm on Kahoot. No, I'm on Quizzes right now. Quizzes and Kahoot. That's my go-to when I can't find a good activity. Because it's really hard what high school is. Because I have a lot of language kids. So, like, well, I have a lot of fluency, too. Which is, whew. Shit is difficult to treat for me. Anyway, because once you specialize in something, it's kind of hard to get away from that. When I was at the elementary school, I did a lot of articulation because there's a lot of little kids. So it's a lot of like a lot of R. R is really hard to learn. I had a couple of THs, S's. I had a couple of artic, but then a lot of it was following directions, inferencing. I had a couple of like storytelling, sequencing. Anyways, I don't care about that. I just wanted to show y'all what I do during the day. Like, I'm obviously, like I said, I'm not gonna show y'all my students or film a therapy session. That's weird as fuck. It's speech therapy, so I don't think it's covered by HIPAA, but still, privacy. Like, I'm not gonna do that. Okay, 12 questions. Nope, that's too hard. This is long. I don't want to get her nothing long. Hopefully she ain't damn here. Why are these questions so long? They're like fucking paragraphs. Okay, I think this is pretty easy enough. Okay, this is as easy as I can freaking make it, dude. Like, oh, I just lost it. Oh, here it is. Gosh, this little girl, she be killing my soul, I swear to God. Anyways, let me go get this child and I'll see y'all in a second. Okay, so it is like, should be like a little bit after 12. I just had to kick my last group out. Sometimes they just be having so much fun that they don't want to leave or they lose track of time. I like to make therapy as fun as possible. I mean, think about it, like you have something that you're not good at or that you need help with, like your speech. It's already like embarrassing enough that you need help for some kids, especially for high school kids, because a lot of them been in therapy for years. Probably even, you know, a long time, like 5-6 years since elementary or middle school they've been in therapy. And you know, sometimes I just like to make therapy fun, especially for high school kids, because again, they've been coming for so long. Like, it's no point in coming in here and doing boring shit and doing worksheets and nah, we're playing games. First off, I don't want to do no worksheets. I don't want to sit there and do worksheets, so you ain't doing no work. Anyways, I'm just trying to finish putting my data in for the clients that I've already seen for the day or students that I have seen for the day. And I have, today's a B day, so I have 2 more sessions. Usually I have about, let me see, I usually have like 5 before lunch and 4 after lunch. So yeah, but some of my kids have graduated from speech. Some of them like to move their groups around so they can be with their friends. I don't care. Again, I don't care. I told my kids, I'm like, when y'all come in here, we can do whatever you want to do. As long as it's related to your goals, we can play whatever game, whatever Kahoot, whatever quizzes. This therapy is for you. You and you've been coming for a long time. So if I set up Jenga, then nobody want to play Jenga with me. They want to play Connect Four. And I go, like, no, we got to play this game. No, we got to do worksheets. No, we got, no. You tell me what you want to do. Y'all are big kids. Big grown high school kids. Some of them literally are grown. So now I get 30 minutes for a lunch, but today I just have a long lunch. I have like an hour, but usually it's 30 minutes. So I'm finna eat and I like to put on Netflix. And right now my current obsession is The Flash. Usually I need some, what you call that spray? The Lysol, so I can just spray the games after they finish it, so we not spreading germs and shit. But that's just some nasty hand sanitizer. Probably COVID, shit stink, but that's what I got. So for lunch, we have a salad. Cause I know I'm trying to, you know, kickstart my little healthy journey, trying to get rid of all of this, you know what I'm saying? So we got us this little Santa Fe salad from Kroger. I love this one, it is so good. It has a chicken, tortillas, cheese, salt, like it's even a fork in here, I think. I hope, because I didn't bring one. But just a little, you know, ASMR. Little salad. And then I have some fruit. So I have strawberries, blueberries, and blackberries. I wanted some blueberries, but they didn't have any. So just some fruit. And then I have a protein bar. Just peanut butter and chocolate chip. I think I have. This shit, 190 calories. There's 16 grams of carbs. And then chips. Because I don't know. I always eat chips with every meal. Excluding breakfast, bitch. I gotta have some chips. Oh, first off, let me tell y'all about the shit. One of the boys said, oh, you smell like my grandma. What? I said, he said, yeah, you smell like my grandma, the cologne should be wearing. And I was like, I don't have any cologne on. He was like, oh, well, you smell like my grandma. Then the other child, so we're playing Connect Four, right? So Jenga Connect Four, y'all know I'm a 90s baby. So I grew up on board games, card games, reading books, being outside. Like, that was my childhood. This boy was like, oh my God, I'm the Connect Four champ. And I'm like, no, you not. Bullshit. I ain't say that to him, but I'm like, no, you not. Ooh. So he ended up whooping my ass. Whooping every other kid's ass in the group. I'm just like, I bet him $1 and I lost, like instantly lost. He was so quick with it. And then I was like, one more time. He was like, you wanna double it? I'm like, all right, we're gonna double it. I lost $2, which I normally don't do. I'm not paying kids, but it's Connect Four. What kid did his age knows how to play Connect Four? Got my ass whooped and I gave him $2. $2, what does it matter? I was riding a train home the other day. I was finna get on the train and this boy was like, I don't know why down here in Georgia, it is so fucking annoying. The way they ask for something, they'll be like, you'll give me this? And he was like, I think the little boy was like, you'll give me $2 so I can get on the bus, or can I have $2 so I can get on the bus? He just asked me, so like, we knew each other, like I was his older sister or something. It was weird, but I just gave him the money. Cause I could say he was nervous. I'm like, the courage that it takes to go up to a stranger and ask for some money. Now, if I ever see him again, he asks for more money. I'm gonna say, where your mama at? What? Is it no fork? Oh. Ooh, I was finna freak out. I was like, I do not look at this little baby fork. But yeah, I know I'm trying to eat healthier. And I'm just being honest with myself. I'm just not in the mood to meal prep. Like, to get the salad mix and then to get all the ingredients and to cook the chicken. I'm like, I'd rather just get a pre-made salad. Everything that I need is in it. I can get different kinds. I want to try other grocery stores if I had a fucking car. But Kroger is walking distance from my house. Y'all know, we just went to the store the other day. I can't go nowhere else unless I call a Lyft. And I feel like that's doing too much. But I want to go to like Whole Foods or something. And see what like kind of healthy shit they got. Like pre-made salads and shit. You know who got a really good salad? Oh my God. And I don't even fuck with that grocery store like that. But Publix, oh my God. I don't know what the hell they put in they damn. Oh, it's just so good. I'm saying I don't know. Like, I didn't get to work there. I definitely used to work at Publix, y'all. I've been working for 11 years. I don't had so many jobs. But the chicken salad, it's a chicken tender salad. So it's basically a salad with chicken tenders on it. It is so good. Like, for real. When I used to work there. Oh, my God. I would fuck that up. You don't need no dress or nothing. Just a little bit of oil and vinegar, salt, pepper, oregano. Delicious. With some nice hot tenders. Put you some cheese up there. Melt that cheese on that thigh. Ooh. So good. But I've had this salad from Kroger before. It's really good. I don't know. I just like it. My go-to salad, though, is a Caesar. I'm finna watch Netflix. I took my shoes off. Yeah, I'm chilling today. Then my last day before the semester's over. Oh, I'm big chilling. That's why we playing games. I bought candy for them, everything. Anyways, The Flash needs me. So I'm gonna watch that on my break. You know, can I just say something that really annoys me? Is when people talk to you while you're trying to fucking eat. Like, they see you on break. they see you chilling. And for some reason, in their little mind, they go, now's a perfect time for me to have a conversation. On her 30-minute pay break, let me fucking bother you. Or you know what's even fucking worse? Oh my God. What's even worse? I keep looking at myself, not at the camera. What's even worse is when you're in the fucking bathroom. Have you ever had somebody talk to you while you're in the bathroom? Why are you talking to me? I'm trying to take a shit. Why are you talking to me? Like, fuck off. That shit is so wild to me. People will really have full-fledged conversations with you when you're on your break. And it's like, you be trying to be like, uh-huh, okay. Like, you think they would get the hint. They don't. Anywho, like I said, I only got 2 more sessions after lunch instead of 4. Today's a shorter day for me. Well, I still have to be here till like 4. And my last session isn't until it's over at 3:20. This way, look a mess. This way, after today, this shit getting put up in a fucking box somewhere. All right. Okay. Oh, I had to speed walk over here. I ain't wanna miss the bus. I'm early. Just got out of school. These kids, oh my God. I usually don't leave this early, but it's the last day before break. I'm pretty sure I finished all my paperwork. So I just want to go home. Whew, I'm tired. My legs hurt. My back has been really tight, which is weird because I thought working out would like make it feel better. Not yet. I walked past the fight, got shoved in the hallway a few times. I cannot stand walking through the hallway with all them kids being in there. I'm like, how did I survive this when I was in school? Like, no, I'm in a rush trying to hurry up and get out of the building. Anyways, yeah, it's like 3:30. I did leave a little early because I usually leave at 4 o'clock, but I left at 3:30. So I'm just waiting for the bus. My wig looks so crazy. I told y'all this wig is going in a box after I'm done. Whew. But yeah, that was it. So now I'm just waiting to go home. I have like an hour and a half, 2 hour maybe commute home. Fuck, I forgot something. I hate that feeling that you like forgot some shit. I hate that shit. I know spirits always look crazy. This lighting is not forgiving me. But yeah, that was my last day after school until next semester. After Christmas, New Year's Eve, and my birthday. And I just told my boss, I ain't coming on my birthday. I'm not. I don't care. She's like, what you gonna be doing? I'm nothing. It's me and my cats gonna hang out. But I'm not gonna be in here. I'm not gonna be at work. Like, I'm not. My birthday's a holiday. I feel like everybody should get a personal day for their birthday. Anyway, should I end the vlog now? I mean, yeah. That was really it. I'm just gonna go home, edit this video, and then I'm gonna chill because my stomach is on one. Matter of fact, I just thought about the fact I definitely had a heating. I had a warming pack that I was sitting with. I don't know what I did with it. Shit. Oh well. Anyways, I guess I can go ahead and end this vlog here since the work day's over. I just wanted you guys to come to work with me because I won't be back till next year. Them kids really scrapping in there, like they was fighting, like it was a bunch of fights. And then the principal was like, that you're not allowed to bring a book bag the last week of school. So fuck. Anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and end this vlog off right here. Thank you all so much for watching today's video, today's vlogmas. I hope you enjoyed it. Please don't forget to smash that red subscribe button down below. Show your girls some love and follow me on social media at Young and Kinky because let's be friends. Duh. Anyways, thank you all so much for watching. I will see y'all tomorrow for Vlogmas Day 13. Vlogmas Day 13. Oh, don't forget, today is 12-12-22. So if you want to make a wish, you want to do some affirmations, you want to manifest something, today's the day to do it. Anyways, I will see y'all tomorrow, okay? Bye!